Learn how SQL Database in Fabric can be the best new database for your low-code and no-code development this week on Data Exposed. Hi, I'm Anna Hoffman, and welcome to this episode of Data Exposed. Today, I'm joined by Sukhwant, a product manager on the SQL team. Sukhwant, why don't you tell us a little bit about what you do?
Anna, thank you so much for calling me in here for the Data Exposed. This is my first time here. My name is Sukhwant. I am a PM in Anna's team working on SQL DB in Fabric, and I'm super excited to share what I have here for the audience today.
Awesome. We're super excited to have you on the show. And folks, today's episode, Sukhwant came to me and said, I think SQL Database in Fabric is the best database for low-code, no-code developers. And I'm super excited to learn more about this. So Sukhwant, can you tell me a little bit more about why you think that SQL Database is great for low-code, no-code?
So SQL Database is our brand new SaaS offering with the same power of Azure SQL underneath it. There are a lot of folks out there who want to learn to create their applications, but when they hear about they have to create a database, they have to do this and that, they get a little bit intimidated because in technology, the learning curve is higher for a lot of people. But with this database, it's all about picking a name, hitting the create button, and voila, your database is provisioned and all the things that you need underneath are hooked up for you. Now, all you have to do is you can use your natural language to ask Copilot, I want to create a table for employees with these tables, and it will give you the syntax that you need, and you can go on and learn from there. You can even take a step back. There is a simple button called Get Sample. You click on it, and you, voila, you have the whole sample database right there for you to start playing with it. So it is as simple as that.
Awesome, cool. It sounds pretty great for getting started. And you know, one question that I have before we get in the demo, because I know you have an awesome demo planned for us, is there anything else people should know or like keep in mind about this before we get into the demo?
Well, I want to highlight five you know, very important things to excite folks to try this product. One, it's super, super easy to create, and it requires no knowledge of databases. You don't need to be an SQL expert or nothing like that. You just need to have the willingness to take a little bit of a challenge and, you know, try it out. You don't have to worry about performance and scalability. Let's say you decide to work on a pet project, and you hit the ground running, and then it starts expanding, and you're like, oh my God, I'm not a DBA. How am I going to take care of the management pieces? All those are built into the software for you. And it comes with a very, very powerful editor. I know all our Azure SQL customers were asking for it. We have made sure it is there. The benefit that the new developer who is trying to experience with this, they don't need to worry about going and installing SSMS or VS Code or ADS to go and do deep work with it. All that functionality is right there in the editor. Another thing I wanted to say was that when you create a database, this is kind of a icing on the cake, I want to say, where the moment you created the database and you started creating your tables and creating the data in it, the data is getting replicated to one lake, which means you can use that one lake copy to either create a report, or you can use this data for whatever data engineering that you have in mind. And lastly, what I want to say is that this SQL database workload is inside Fabric, which means it comes with all the cool things that are there for Fabric, you know, security, you know, if you want to use data flow, data pipelines, you want to use GraphQL to create your API layer so that you can create a web application and hook with it quickly. And CI/CD is built in it. There's so much more. I don't have time to cover everything. And I know Anna has plans to do a deep dive into each and every part of the product. And I think you are going to love it. So stay tuned for that.
No, I love it. This is great. Now, for folks who haven't seen it before, like, I'd love to see it in action. Can we take a look?
Yes. Let's see if I can do a justice to this cool new SaaS software for you guys. So here we are, I'm in my workspace and I'm about to create a database. I'm going to click on a new item and I'm going to search for SQL database preview. I click on it, I choose a name, that was a hard part for me. So I pick the name and I hit the create button and my database has started provisioning. It takes about less than a minute, I would say. And you are presented with this editor. So there's a lot available on this, and I don't want to confuse you. So I wanted to keep it simple. So you can click on the sample data tile to create your data. Or if you want to create with your hand, you can take the help of templates, new table, new views to write with code with your own hands. If you are curious, you have to do that. To keep this simple, I'm going to just use the sample data to create the database. And once the data is loaded, you'll get a message there, the database is loaded. And, this sample data is created a sales LT for you. And there are a bunch of tables in there, address, customer, all filled with data. Now you are ready to write your SQL and get the things moving. So while the data was getting created and this database getting set up, you'd also notice that I told you that mirroring is happening behind the scene. So you can go and check that part by clicking on the top right corner. And you can switch the view to SQL Analytics endpoint. And this will show you all the data that got replicated for you. All right, so we have the data at two places. One is your operational data, OLTP data. This one is your Parquet file, read-only data for you. Now coming back into the SQL database, I am going to take you a step further. And what I thought was, let me show you how easy it is for you to create a Power App where you can connect this, your Power App, to the data behind it. So over here, I already have a connection, but I'll show you how to create a connection. It's super, super simple. You click on New, and then you look for SQL Server. Once you click on it, I chose Microsoft Entra Authentication and hit Create. It's as simple, creating a connection, because I already have it, so I will go and use that. Once I go there, I need to know what my server is, what is my database. So I'll be going back to get that settings. So I'll go into the settings part. I'll go to connection strings, and I'll pick the data source. And I'll pick the database name from initial catalog. That's it. My connection is set. My underneath piping is ready for it to work on. It's going to take a few minutes. And then it shows me all the tables that you already saw were there. I am going to target the customers table just to show you what happens. The moment I pick the customer table, it will automatically create a page for me that I can use to add, edit, and delete the data inside that table. It does have a search capability, so I'll be searching for a customer. And then I pick that customer to see all the content inside that table. And then let's just modify it and see if what I change here, that change gets reflected there or not. So I hit the save. I'm taking the customer name here. And then I'll go back and I'll write some SQL. You can see all this is happening within the editor. And watch, I just told the copilot, I said, create a query to get data for a customer based on the company name. See, it gave me the query. I don't need to be a SQL expert to be able to do that. So now I just have to replace the company name there. It returns me two records. The second one is the one that we changed. See, Christina's test. So that's it.
Wow.
That's the new SaaSified SQL DB for all of you guys to try. So.
Yeah, it's definitely interesting to see how much more simple the experience is, and how we're kind of optimizing for AI here.
Yes.
And then a lot of the maybe autonomous aspects behind the scene that you don't even see because you don't even have to worry about them.
Yes.
So yes. I thought it was super cool. I think it would be a great scenario for low code, no code. Thanks so much, Sukhwant, for bringing this topic to us. For our viewers, we'd love for you to try this out. So go ahead, take a look, leverage the Fabric free trial. You can get 60 days for free with SQL Database and Fabric and everything else that goes along with it. And you can check out how easy it is to set up a Power App. If you like this episode, go ahead and give it a like, leave us a comment, let us know what you think. We'll put some links in the description for you to learn more, and we hope to see you next time on Data Exposed.